Measurement of Segments, Level 1. Geometry was initially used to solve problems involving measurements on the earth. The word geometry comes from the Greek word geo, which means earth, and metri, which means measure. So this is the mathematics that allows us to carry out measurements on the earth. Although the earth is essentially spherical in shape, when we view the earth in small regions, it appears to be flat. This is why in many practical situations where measurements are involved, the earth is assumed to be flat and considered to be part of a plane. You can think of a plane as a sheet of paper of points with no thickness, stretched tightly and extending infinitely in all directions. Geometry that involves measurements in a plane is referred to as plane geometry. And in this course, the majority of the topics that we will cover will allow us to solve two-dimensional planar geometry problems. Later on in this course, we will use our new planar geometry knowledge and solve simple three-dimensional geometry problems. The field in geometry that deals with three-dimensional figures is known as solid geometry. In the following series of videos, we will learn how to measure line segments. In the previous video, we defined a line segment, also referred to as simply a segment, as a straight line that is made up of points that has a definite beginning and end. These two points are referred to as the endpoints of the segment. Because segments have a definite beginning and an end, they can be measured and have a unique length. We measure segments by using instruments such as rulers and meter sticks. We may use any convenient length as a unit of measure. Common units include inches, feet, yards, millimeters, centimeters, and meters. For example, segment AB measures 1 inch, and segment CD measures 5 centimeters. In geometry, the way we denote the measurement of a segment is by writing the endpoints of the segment. For example, the measurement of segment AB is 1 inch, and the measurement of segment CD is 5 centimeters. Notice the distinction between denoting a line segment, a geometric figure, and denoting the measurement or length of the line segment, which represents a numerical value. If you want to identify the line segment, we draw a horizontal segment, also known as a bar, on top of the letters. If we want to denote the measurement or length of the line segment, then we only denote the endpoints, and do not draw a horizontal segment or bar on top of the letters. We can also use a number line to find the measurement of a segment. The real number associated with a point on a line is called the coordinate of the point. For example, the following line segment is formed by point P and point Q, with point P located at the coordinate negative 4, and point Q located at the coordinate positive 2. Usually, only integers are labeled in a number line, because it is impossible to label all the real numbers, like fractions or decimals, since there are infinite real numbers. The measurement of this line segment can be determined by measuring how far apart the endpoints are from one another. In other words, we measure the distance between the points. In this case, the measurement of segment PQ is 6. We can define the distance between point A and point B as a non-negative difference between their coordinates. For example, segment PQ can be found by subtracting the coordinates of the line segment. In this case, we can subtract negative 4 from positive 2, or subtract positive 2 from negative 4. Since we want the numbers to be non-negative, we take the absolute value of the result. In general, if a line segment has one endpoint located at the coordinate A and the second endpoint located at the coordinate B, then the length of the line segment is given by the absolute value of A minus B, or the absolute value of B minus A. Notice that we are not assigning a unit, such as inches or centimeters, to this length. When the unit is not explicitly stated, we can either leave our answer as a number, such as 6, or we can say that the line segment measures 6 units in length. Now let's talk about congruent segments. In geometry, two objects that have the same size and shape are called congruent. For many geometry figures, we can give a more precise definition of what it means to be congruent. Later on in this course, we will define congruent angles, congruent triangles, and congruent circles. Let's first define congruent segments. Congruent segments are segments that have the same lengths. In other words, the segments have equal measurements. In the figure shown, segments AB, CD, and EF are congruent. To indicate that segment AB and segment CD have equal lengths, or to denote that the distance from point A to point B equals the distance from point C to point D, we write AB equals CD, without using the line segment or bar symbol on top of the letters. To indicate that segment AB and segment CD are congruent, we use the following symbol. This symbol uses a tilde above the equal sign, and is read as segment AB is congruent to segment CD. This statement can be used interchangeably, meaning that if segment AB is congruent to segment CD, then segment CD is congruent to segment AB. Remember to use equality for numbers and congruence for geometric figures. We can also use identical tick marks to indicate congruent segments in a diagram or figure. For example, in the following figures, a single tick mark is used to show that these two line segments are congruent. If multiple segments need to be labeled as congruent, then we can use double or triple tick marks. For example, double tick marks are used to show that these line segments are congruent, and triple tick marks are used to show that these line segments are congruent. All right, and this is the basics of measuring line segments. We can find the length of a line segment by using a ruler with an appropriate unit, or we can use a number line and find the absolute difference of the segment's endpoint coordinates. We can also identify and label congruent segments by using tick marks in a diagram, or by using the congruence symbol, which tells us that two line segments have the same length. In our next video, we will go over simple examples that makes use of the concepts learned so far.